Today's guilty plea in the Danziger case and the news of a potentially wide-reaching NOPD cover-up could further erode a public trust in the department that some say was already on shaky ground.
Wow. Wow.
Donatus King, president of the local NAACP, was stunned when he learned the details surrounding the guilty plea.
Finally, it's starting to come to light. The truth is starting to come to light.
King says he always hears from people in the community about trust issues with police. And now, as a member of Mayor-elect Mitch Landrieu's task force to select a new police chief, he's even more concerned about public perception.
How can the community have confidence in a police force when we have admissions about conspiracies to plant evidence, conspiracies to falsify reports?
I was devastated. I really was.
Henry Dean is the president of the Fraternal Order of Police in New Orleans, which includes 1,200 active officers. Dean says some of them are concerned about what they'll encounter during stops.
I do see some people in society, and maybe understandably so, saying, what are you going to do, cover this up too? And that word's going to be thrown around. I've seen it happen in the past.
So to change the perception of some in the future, a lot falls on the shoulders of the incoming mayor now as he decides the next superintendent.
There's not an indictment of the entire force, that there are members on the force that are good, and we need to make sure that they're able to do their job and remove those bad apples.
I think everybody has to be realistic, and most people are realistic, and I hope the new superintendent, whoever he or she is also realistic. You may be told you have a clean slate, but you've got to erase that other slate first, and it's going to take some doing.
Henry Dean says the Fraternal Order of Police is instructing NOPD officers to act professionally, cooperate with the authorities, and to do so with representation.